Hello everyone, I am Dr. Meet Kumar and I am consultant in hematology and bone marrow transplant department at Fortis Memorial Research Institute, Gurugram. Today I will be talking to you about utility of bone marrow transplant in hematological disorders. So first of all, what is bone marrow transplant? So bone marrow transplant essentially is a curative treatment available for many of the hematological disorders that includes both cancerous and non-cancerous. The basic principle on which the bone marrow transplant relies is that we have to get the stem cells either from the patient or from one of the donors. We have to give chemotherapy to the patient so as to kill whatever the remaining stem cells, what are the remaining cancer cells or the bad non-cancerous cells are there in his body, and return back the stem cells that we have adequately collected. So this, as I said, it can be of two types. It can be either autologous, that means that the patient's own stem cells will be used to cure him. And in case of allogeneic stem cell transplant, there will be a specific donor that will be used, whose stem cells will be used to cure the patient. So basic difference between autologous and allogeneic stem cell transplant depends essentially on the source of stem cells. Now, what are the common diseases for which this can be used? For the autologous transplant, there are various indications for which autologous transplant is as of date recommended, FDA approved, and the recognized treatment for the conditions called like lymphoma, both Hodgkin's and non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Myeloma, multiple myeloma, that is a type of Waldenstrom, there is a type of plasma cell dyscrasia, there is Waldenstrom leukemia, Waldenstrom's macroglobulinemia, there is multiple sclerosis and a host of autoimmune disorders for which now recently the world bodies have approved the use of autologous stem cell transplant as the curative and disease modifying treatment. As the allogeneic stem cell transplant is concerned, it is usually reserved for patients who have aggressive hematological disorders that involves leukemias. That includes what? Acute myeloid leukemia, acute lymphoblastic leukemia, myelodysplastic leukemia, myelodysplastic syndrome, and the patients who have been refractory to the autologous stem cell transplant or disease, or the patients whose diseases have come back after autologous stem cell transplants. So these are the common indications for which autologous and allogeneic stem cell transplants are recommended. Now, do all the blood cancers or blood disorders require a stem cell transplant? No, that's a myth, that's a misnomer, that's a misunderstanding that all the patients will require a stem cell transplant. I will say almost 30 to 40% of the patients that comprise a hematological disorders may need a stem cell transplant in their life. But yes, that has to be understood that that's the only treatment for majority of the patients that provides a curative alternative to other alternative treatments. Is there any risk involved with the stem cell transplant? Yes, there is some minor risk involved in the stem cell transplant, more so with the allogeneic stem cell transplant. There are chances that the donor stem cells that have gone inside the patient may have a fight with in the patient's body, and that is called as graft versus host disease. There is prolonged immunosuppression in the patient's body because of the impaired host and the graft immunity, and that leads to a risk, increased risk of infections for some time. But usually these things are manageable in almost 70%, 60% of the patients. It is manageable with the currently available treatment. So in short, we can say that yes, that's a curative treatment. There is curative treatment available for many of the blood disorders, and we should try for this type of treatments whichever patients require them. So the message to all of us, all our friends, is that don't be caught in wrong news. Try to inquire the correct information, because right information at right time, at right treatment when it is given, it can be life-saving for many a people. Just keep this thing in mind. Please do get in touch with us. Send your queries. We'll be very happy to serve you all. Thank you.